wrote to another Christian in Rome. Amen. To proclaim that Jesus is the Son of God. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Those who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." One verse in your hearing, amen. The word of God, for the people of God, be blessed in the presence of God. Amen. 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 We want to talk, amen, from the subject, loving like Jesus loved. Loving like Jesus loved. Amen. We watched our young people do Black History this month, and normally we were trying to tie it in, but I told you the week before I got ready to go to Pensacola, we need to talk more about love. This month of February, amen, we need to lean more toward love. History, amen, is already written, but somehow I shared with you that history have messed us up because of de-socialization and de-sexualization, amen, amen, and de-humanization, and all of those other D's, Reverend Davis, have messed us up, and somehow we don't know how to love one another. And I told y'all, amen, I preach from the subject, amen, it's all about love. I think we was over in John, that 13th chapter, amen, and that 31st through 36th verse. Is that right? And we talked about it's all about love. And I told y'all, amen, that I was going to give you three attributes of love. And I said that I would close it out next Sunday because I was getting ready to go out of town and tell you about the filial love, and the eros love, and the agape love. Amen. And I said, but those are not the three aspects that I'm going to talk about. Let's bring it back up today. I said, I want to talk about, first of all, the love that God have for us. Amen. Amen. Y'all got that. Y'all still got that. Because see, somebody might feel like nobody loves you. Somebody might feel like don't nobody care about you. But you need to know that no matter what goes on in your life, God loves you. Amen. 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 And then we talked about, amen, our love for God. Amen. I told you that love is reciprocal, amen, and it's a two-way thing. Somebody wrote a song one time. Y'all may be saved all your life, but they say it's hard loving somebody. Oh, y'all ought to get with me now. But don't get too holy today, amen, when they don't love you back, amen. Love is reciprocal. It's a two-way street, this thing called love. And watch me prove my point. Now, John said we love him because he first loved us. And we talked about how we love God, and we come to the conclusion that the songwriter was right. Falling in love with Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to me. And then Mother Touchstone, we talked about brotherly love. Amen. How we are to love one another, how we ought to be our brother and sister keeper, amen. And John talked about that. He said, how can we say we love God when we have not seen and don't love our brethren who we see every day? And we concluded that thing. We wrapped it up, tied it up, packed it all up, and packaged it neatly, and come to the conclusion 2 weeks ago. We have concluded that it's all about love. Then we need to know how to love. And if we're going to love, we've got to love like Jesus loved. love. And the question is then, the question is, how did Jesus love? First thing you got to know, Jesus loved selflessly. To somebody was at 8 o'clock, one of the kids wrote it down. Somebody better get that. Jesus loved selflessly. He didn't look at everything as being about himself. Paul discovered that when he said he was in the form of God, thought it not a robbery to be equal with God, and made of himself no reputation, amen, but took upon himself the form of a servant and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. He wasn't looking at what he could get from us, but he was looking at what he could do for us. And follow me. It's not all about you. It's not all about you, but it's all about others. Are you hearing me? It's not about thinking of yourself, but thinking of self as less. Oh, somebody, that went on somebody's head. Somebody missed that, amen. It's not about thinking of self, or what I want to do, or what I should be doing. It's not about you. It's about what you can do for somebody else. I wish I had somebody. It's not about what folks can do for you, what folks can give you, how much they love you. You just to love them anyhow. Are y'all with me? You got to love them. Will cause you to have some pains. Are y'all with me? I don't need no witness. I got one that rolled with me here. I know y'all thinking it's Christian, but I have another from part in the car. Y'all don't hear me. He'll tell you that I went out of my way. I opened some blind eyes. I did all I could for them, but yet they ran me out of town. Some folks will get on your nerves, try to run you down, wear you out. The second thing, you gotta love understandingly. Are y'all hearing me? You know how we get in the church? We get so saved, so sanctified, so Holy Ghost filled, two letters behind our name. Good job to go to.